Thank you. Today, we'll see four recipes to get from zero tests with effect to comfortable testing everyday scenarios. Okay. And so first, we should probably start with the templates. Like, how do you even set up a test for an effect? This one is easy. It's always the same steps. One, you declare the test using whatever test framework, Jest, Vtest, whatever. Two, gen, that's where all the test code goes. Three, provide the required dependencies, if any, and four, run the effect. And that's it. Like, gen, provide run promise, nothing fancy, but it's easy to parse visually, and it gives you a reliable structure. In fact, every example in this talk is going to use it, starting with testing failure. Any kind of failure, error, defect, interruption, failure. And so, new test, exact same structure again, gen provide run promise. And this test focuses on the create method of our user repository. And we want to test that the creation fails when the user already exists. So to trigger this case, we just have to create the same user twice. And now what we want is to verify that the result of that second call, the one that we expect to fail, is indeed a failure. But how do we catch that failure to How do we catch that failure to assert on it? Because right now, the test is just going to crash because create is going to crash. To do that, we're going to use effect.exit. With this, our effect will now always succeed, even if it failed, even if it died, whatever happened. So the test won't crash anymore, and it will always succeed with an exit data type that contains the status of the effect and the data it completed with. Meaning we can take the result of that second call and assert on its exit status. Here we expect the effect to have exited, to have completed as a failure, and more specifically, a failure containing a duplicate user error. If instead we want to test that the effect died, there is exit.die. If you want to test that it was interrupted, there is exit.isInterrupted. And there's more, but basically, if you want to assert on the exit status of an effect, exit is what you need. Next recipe, manipulating time in tests, which is usually tedious, fortunately, not with effect. So, new test again, same structure again. This test focuses on the freeze service. So sometimes we have to stop or freeze the deployments of our application. And this is what we use. So here we start a freeze. Start takes a timeout of a given duration, here 10 minutes. And we want to test that the freeze is no longer active after the given timeout. But how do we advance the clock 10 minutes to trigger that timeout? Well, because under the hood, the implementation of freeze uses effects clock to get the time, so this. It means that in our test, we can leverage the test clock to override and manipulate the clock time. Meaning we can simply adjust the time by a given duration, and it will change the clock time. We can also directly set the time if needed using set time and passing it an instance. One important thing to note, though, is that when using the test clock, time is frozen. It starts at zero and stays at zero unless you change it manually. So here, before the adjustment, wherever you might call clock.currentTime millis, you will always get zero. It only changes after the adjustment, and it will stay at that new adjusted time forever unless we adjust it again. Okay, so we know how to manipulate time, but what if we can't? What if start was blocking? How can we adjust the time to trigger the timeout if we're stuck at the step before, waiting for that timeout to happen? To do that, we're going to send the effect away using fork. To be clear, we are still starting the effect. It is running in the background, but we are not waiting for it to finish anymore, meaning it's not blocking us, and so the test can move forward, and we can do our time adjustment. And if we need to assert on the result of the effect that we sent away, fork returns a handle to that effect. So we can take that handle and bring the process back to wait for its result using fiber.join. So we know how to move time forward, even when we are blocked by effects that are stuck because they are waiting for time to move forward. So basically, the test is done. There's only one thing left. Since we're using the test clock, we have to provide it. Its implementation is part of the test context, so we have to import it and provide it. Quick note, I used two provides here because it's easier to read for the example, but it's a regular layer. There is nothing special about it. And that's it, three lines to master time, in effect. Pretty cool. That test clock service, though, is pretty interesting, right? It allows us to do stuff that we can't do with the regular clock, right? We can't adjust the time with the regular clock. And it overrides the clock transparently, meaning if you use the regular clock, what you actually get is the test clock time, but you don't know that. That's transparent. I call that a shadow service because it runs things from the shadows while no one is aware of its existence. It's a totally made-up name, but it's very useful, so let's see how we can create our own. So, new test again. The subject under test here with the longest name ever is send by subscription email to all non-paying customers. Okay, and we want to check that we indeed do not send that email to paying customers. What we'd like to have is something like this, mailer that has been sent to customer, email. So a way to know if an email was sent to someone or not. But it's not part of the mailer interface and we don't want it there, so let's create our own shadow service. I'm going to call this the test mailer because I have a wild imagination. And make it an effect service. Since we're going to override the mailer with it, we have to support its operations. So let's require those. And now on top of that, that's where the fun begins. We can add any additional operation that we want. In this case, has been sent to. And so now we have two services, right? We have the mailer and the test mailer. And we want to make sure that if a change happens in one, it's reflected in the other. If I change the time using the test clock, anyone using the regular clock should get the test clock time. And the simplest way to do that is probably to have both share the same instance. We're going to do that using a layer. So here we define a new layer using unwrap effect. Unwrap effect will allow us to turn an effect into any number of layers. The effect we are going to generate those layers from is makeTestMailer, which, shocker, gives us back an instance of the test mailer. So we can take that instance and provide both services, the mailer and the test mailer, the same instance. And that's it. Since they share the same instance, any change in one would be reflected in the other. The only thing left is to update the tests. So now back to the test. We can add the new layer to our dependencies. And in the test code, instead of using the regular mailer, we can use the test mailer to access our new operations. And all this from the shadows, while the production code stays the same. Last, before I end, if you use Vitest, I strongly suggest you use this package. You'll get better errors, less boilerplate, prop testing, and other things. You can find the complete code for all the examples on my GitHub here. That's it for me. Thank you to the Effect team for inviting me, to Evryg, my company, for sending me here, and thank you to all of you for being here at lunchtime.